the liver, as I was mentioning earlier, has a thing called phase one. And what it does is it activates it. So a good test for this, those people out there who can actually drink coffee and then go to sleep immediately, it's probably because your phase one enzymes are not functioning properly. We want phase one and phase two to act directly equally. So as you're activating things, phase one is activating things, you're equally detoxifying and deactivating things. The example with coffee, caffeine doesn't have an activity, all the activities you think about, unless it's been activated. So drinking coffee and then sleeping means you're not activating, your phase one enzymes are not activating that caffeine. So from there, as I mentioned, the free radicals are formed. That activated compound, let's just take caffeine, enters the bloodstream, goes to its target cells. It has a certain half-life, that means it lasts a certain amount of time. And then from there, it goes back into the blood, into the venous blood, goes back to the liver again. And the liver goes, okay, you've had enough of this, I have to deactivate it. There's six different pathways. There's methylation, glucuronidation, sulfation, adding an amino acid, glucuronidation, and a thing called glutathione. Glutathione, there's a lot of research and excitement around glutathione. That's what red grape skins are all about because it contains a high amount of a thing called resveratrol, which increases glutathione. Glutathione gets rid of a lot of those heavy, heavy toxins that we worry about in our body. So then after the liver decides which way it's going to detoxify, then if it becomes a gas, then it goes into the lungs and it's excreted. So we all know that once we have a great Caesar salad with a pile of garlic in it, for instance, you're going to have that allicin get activated by the liver, goes into the cells. Once it has its great antimicrobial action and antiplatelet, all the other great things that it does, then it goes out as a gas into the lungs and gets excreted. And that's why we don't want to sleep with our loved ones after they've had a Caesar salad. If it's a fat, what happens is it goes in with the bile. The gallbladder's job is to turn it into a salt. Then it's excreted into the small intestines as bile. Bile has a lot of functions. It's a natural laxative. It conjugates a lot of things. But then that's another way that the fats get excreted out into your stool. So through the large intestines. If it's water soluble, then that toxin, deactivated toxin, will then go to the kidney. And then the kidney creates urine and then you pee it out. So is everybody clear about the elimination organs? I'm talking about these primarily because the hormone balance is incredibly important for good liver function. And if you have inflammation in your gut, in your digestive tract, your small intestines is attached to the bile duct, which is attached to the gallbladder, which is attached to the liver. So if you have inflammation in your gut, you're going to have inflammation in the liver. What tends to happen is that phase one upregulates and you get a lot of changes, enzyme changes, so you don't actually have good hormone balance. And that's the holistic reason why liver and gut is so important in hormonal health.